गुरु रेव गदर गुरु मेव भजे गुरु नैव सहास्मि नमो गुरवे न गुरो परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो। संस्कृतं कथमस्ति? संस्कृतं सुलभमस्ति। किमर्थं? संस्कृतभाषा सरला भाषा, अतः वयं सर्वे संस्कृतं अवश्यं पठामः। ओके, विल डिस्कस द आंसर्स। सो द फर्स्ट मेन, सो प्लीज बी रेडी एंड प्लीज रेज योर हैंड्स। नमस्ते।
सरस्वती नद्याः उद्गम स्थानं किम्?
सरस्वती नद्याः उद्गम स्थानं त्रिजीनम्।
त्रिजीनम्, समीचीनम्। यस, नेक्स्ट वन।
नद्यः कस्याः आधारभूताः सन्ति?
नद्यः भारतीय संस्कृतेः आधारभूताः सन्ति।
वेरी गुड।
जलाभावे किं किं संभवति?
आई विल शेयर द आंसर। दिस इज देयर इन द लास्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ द लेसन। जलाभावे कृषिकाः कृषिं कर्तुं न पारयन्ति, अनन्तरं उद्यमाः स्थगिताः भवन्ति, खगाः मृगाः च नश्यन्ति। खगाः प्रणश्यन्ति, मृगाः च नश्यन्ति। देयर आर सेट ऑफ फोर सेंटेंसेस। जलाभावे किं किं भवति? इन स्केर्सिटी ऑफ वाटर, इफ वाटर इज नॉट देयर, व्हाट विल हैपन? सो दीस ऑल थिंग्स, दीस आर द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस इफ यू डोंट प्रोटेक्ट वाटर। सो दैट इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन द टेक्स्ट बुक with in the last paragraph. Okay, so
धन्यवाद।
अस्तु, the next question।
भारतीयः नदी जलं किमित भावयन्ति?
भारतीयः नदी जल तीर्थमिति स्वीकुर्वन्ति।
भावयन्ति, स्वीकुर्वन्ति, both are correct। तीर्थम, नदी जलं तीर्थमिति, answer is किमिति तीर्थम इति। Okay, तीर्थमिति भावयन्ति। Okay, next question।
भारत देशे प्रधानतया कति नद्यः प्रवहन्ति?
भारत देशे प्रधानतया सप्त नद्यः प्रवहन्ति।
वेरी गुड, सप्त नद्यः प्रवहन्ति।
पर्वतराजः कः?
पर्वतराजः हिमालय।
राइट, पर्वतराजः हिमालयः, दैट्स करेक्ट। ओके, नेक्स्ट।
केभ्यः नद्यः प्रवहन्ति?
फ्रॉम वेयर, व्हाट इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ द रिवर्स, दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन। केभ्यः, पंचमी विभक्ति ही बहुवचन। इट्स अगेन देयर इन द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ द लेसन इटसेल्फ।
पर्वतेभ्यः नद्यः,
पर्वतेभ्यः, द आंसर इज पर्वतेभ्यः। ओके, पर्वतेभ्यः नद्यः प्रभवन्ति। ओके, नेक्स्ट। गंगोत्री कस्याः?
गंगोत्री कस्याः नद्याः उद्गमस्थानम् अस्ति?
गंगोत्री उद्गम स्थानम गंगा,
गंगायाः। राइट, वी विल हैव टू यूज षष्ठी विभक्ति। कस्याः? गंगा नद्याः और गंगायाः, बोथ आर फाइन।
गंगोत्री, गंगा,
ये नदीनां कृते कृतज्ञाः भवेयुः।
ये नदीनां कृते कृतज्ञाः भवेयुः। जन्तवः सर्वे नदीना कृते कृतज्ञाः भवेयुः।
वेरी गुड, सर्वे जन्तवः नदीनां कृते कृतज्ञाः भवेयुः। ओके, द लास्ट क्वेश्चन, आई लास्ट क्वेश्चन। जनाः केन रोगिणः भवन्ति?
जनाः मलिन जलपानेन रोगिणः भवन्ति।
वेरी गुड, मलिन जलपानेन रोगिणः भवन्ति। वेरी गुड, धन्यवादाः। फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। ओके, नर्मदा नद्याः उत्तम स्थानम्?
अमरकंटकम्।
ताः डैश प्रातः स्मरणीयाः?
ताः नद्यः प्रातः स्मरणीयाः।
वेरी गुड, ताः नद्यः प्रातः स्मरणीयाः। भारते प्रधानतया डैश प्रवहन्ति?
भारतीय प्रधानतयाः नद्यः गंगा,
नो, देयर इज वन, one word. Okay.
Nadyah, nadyah pravahat.
Nadyah pravahat. How many? How many?
Sapta nadyah pravahanti.
Last one, nadi dash papanam.
Nadi jananam, jananam papanam haranaya cha.
No. So it is part of the shloka, last shloka that we have seen. Nadi tapa vinashaya papanam haranaya cha. So we'll have to tell, that is the answer here. Tapa vinashaya. We need to complete that phrase, fill in the blanks. Okay. The next set of questions. Write the fourth word. Basically, there is a
Vijinam. Yes. Fourth word is Saraswati is Trijinam.
Very good.
Next is Pravatebhya Chaturthi Vibhakti Bharatasya Shashti Vibhakti.
Very good.
Shobhate Atmane Padam Bhavati Parasme Padam.
Very good.
Atah Abhyayam Sah Sarvanama.
Sa Nama
Padam. Sa Nama Padam.
Sarvanama Api Samichinam Eva.
Okay.
We are classified into three main categories. One is Kriyapadam, Namapadam and Avyayam.
Oh, yes, right.
Okay. So in Namapadam, you can still have further classifications. So where like Sarvanama Shabda. Sarvanama Shabda is also part of Namapada. So Avyayam is a separate category. Namapadam is a separate category. And Kriyapadam is a separate category. So these are the three classification of words if you see. And based on that, we can answer it. Dhanyavadaha. Well answered. Okay. We'll go to the next set of questions. Sandhim vibhajya nama likhata.
Himalayah, hima plus alayah, savarna dirgha sandhi.
Very good. Hima plus alayah, savarna dirgha sandhi. Yes. Second one.
Mita plus upayogah, guna sandhi.
Very good. Mita plus upayogah, guna sandhi. Yeah, you can answer the rest two as well.
Adhunikah plus udyame, adhunikah plus udyamena guna sandhi.
Very good.
And jala plus abhavah savarna dirgha sandhi.
Very good. All answered correctly. Adhunika udyamaha mita upayogaha etc. Well answered. Okay. So so in these means, how to split the sandhi? I have also been telling this also in the previous classes. So identify where there is a probability of the sandhi. And then when you split, both the words should have its meaning and independent existence. So these are some of the things that we'll have to consider. And based on how the split is done, if suppose say there was an okara, ekara or okara or arkara, if these three are there, then it is guna sandhi. If a, any dirgha is there, a, e, u, etc., then it will be part of savarna dirgha sandhi. If aikara or aukara is there, then it will be vriddhi sandhi. If suppose yakara, vakara, rakara or lakara is there, in such cases, then it will be yan sandhi. So these are the ways you will have to identify which sandhi it is and then make a proper split of it. Okay, dhanyavadaha. We'll go to the next domain.
Aham, avam, vayam.
Very good.
Sa, te, taha. Saraha, sarau, saraha. Parvatarajaha, parvatarajau. Parvatarajaha, jalasya, jalayoho, jalanam.
Very good. Uttamam. Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha.
So, we'll have to remember the Shabda Rupani. So, if you remember the Shabda Rupani, all these answers or these questions are simple and we'll be able to answer them without any mistakes. So, please keep remembering, practicing the Shabda Rupani without fail. Shabda Rupani and of course, Dhatu Rupani. Okay, we'll go to the next main. Pariyaya padam likhata.
Nadi Sarita.
Sarit. Okay.
Sarita, Samudra Sindhu.
No. Sarit or Apaga. These are the two possible answers. The Pariyaya padam. Sarit. And it is not Sarita, it is Sarit. Okay.
Sarit. Jalam Toyam.
Okay.
Jantava Mrugaha Prani Matraha.
Okay. Praninaha, that is sufficient. Jantavaha Jivinaha Praninaha. Mrugaha is also Mrugaha. Will not be fine because mriga is like animal only. Jantuhu in general means any living organism. So that is the reason. Okay. So sure. Dhanyavadaha.
Yes. Prataha sayam. Kritaknyaha akritaknyaha.
Okay.
Astikaha nastikaha.
Right.
Papanam punyanam.
Okay, very good. So here one important thing, kritagnyaha means one who can remember, who are basically grateful. The opposite for this, akritagnyaha is also fine, but that will not suit the correct in the correct way. Kritaghnaha. Ghna means those who kill, who help them, or basically who are not grateful to someone. Okay, so kritaghnaha would be the correct or the apt answer. Okay, and then astikaha, nastikaha, there's no problem with that. And papanam, punyanam, this is also correct.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so akritagnyaha is also fine. I would not say that is a wrong answer. Kritagnyaha and na kritagnyaha will become akritagnyaha. So that means say not grateful. But kritaghnaha, there's already a word like which means this. So we can make use of that.
Okay, so, thank you.
Okay, let's proceed. So padanam artham likhata. So we'll have to write this in English or basically in the regional language that you'll be.
Krushikaha, farmers.
Right.
Pravahaha, flow.
Flood, basically. Okay.
Flood.
Flow also is fine. Yes.
Kalushi kritam, polluted.
Very good. Kalushi kritam, polluted. So nadi pravahaha, yes. Flow also you can take. Also, flood is another meaning that also is there available. So, flow slash flood, you can write both of them. Dhanyavadaha. Next, we'll go to this. We'll have to use this in our own sentences. I should tell the meaning of this word so that it will be understood by everyone. You can try on your own as well. So, pratyaham means every day.
Astika jana evam nadi pratyaham samsthanti.
Samsmaranti. Okay, that is a correct answer. But also try to make it a simple sentence which is easier. Like aham pratyaham devam namami is also a correct valid sentence. So aham pratyaham, like I bow down to the god every day, pratyaham. Aham pratyaham samskritam pathami. I read samskritam every day. So it's not necessary that you should write a sentence exactly what is there in the textbook. Based on the word, you can create or write your own sentences. Okay, make it simple.
Samsarati is always remember, na?
Right, remember it well, basically.
Samsarati jalam jivanam, is this correct?
Jivanam jalam iti.
Jal is life, always remember jal is life.
Ha, that's what. Iti ramaha or balaha samsparati or janaha samsparati. So Achha. That way you'll have to put something, but it is, we can understand that way. So.
Okay.
Yeah, because jalam jivanam iti kaha samsmarati, who has to remember? Everyone, Alva. Everyone, right? So sarvaha jalam jivanam iti samsmarati. You can ask that way. You can tell that way. Okay. Otherwise, samsmarati prahladaha harim samsmarati or ramaha or say sita ramam samsmarati. Any of these sentences are possible. Okay, next one.
Sarvada
means all time, okay. Always.
I've written book answer only. Sarvada nadinam krite kritagya bhavayu.
Ha, okay, that is also fine. Sarvada sarvepi nadinam krite kritagyaha bhavayu. That is also right. Or otherwise, simple is sarvada satyameva vadamaha. Sarvada samskritam pathamaha. I'm just giving simple examples other than what is there in the textbook. But only thing is you need to understand what this word means, sarvada. Sarvada means all time.
All time.
Yeah. Next.
Vina.
Vina.
Jalen vina mriga pranashyanti.
Very good. Jalena vina mrigaha pranashyanti. Or jalena vina vayam na jivamaha. Jalam vina meenaha na jivati. Any of these sentences is fine. Vayum vina na jivamaha, etc. So only important aspect that we should pay attention to is whenever we use vina, corresponding noun should be either in dvitiya vibhakti or tritiya or panchami. These can be used in any interchangeably you can use. Jalam vina, jalena vina, jalat vina. All three are correct combinations. Dhanyavadaha, Bhagini, well answered. Okay, we shall do the last main. So here again, so this has been shown here, the same thing, like whenever we use Vina, the corresponding word should be in Dvitiya, Tritiya or Panchami.
Adim Vina Jeevanam Kashtam Bhavati.
Right. You can answer in any of these, any of the vibhaktis actually.
I wanted to ask that if you say Nadya Vina, so also right. Should be correct.
Correct. All three mean okay. The same. So okay. Whenever Vina comes, we'll have to use either Dvitiya or Tritiya or Panchami. These can be used interchangeably. The okay. Sentence meaning remains the same.
Okay. And since it is tad tena vina trinam api na chalati.
That's right.
Pustakena vina pathanam na bhavati.
Right.
Jnanena vina moksha na siddhyati.
Right. All four are correct. So we can actually use any of the vibhaktis. So basically nadim, then nadya or nadyaha. Nadyaha vina na jivanti. Nadim Vina, Nadya Vina, all three are possible. Same way is with Tena, Tam Vina, Tena Vina, Tasmat Vina, Pustakam, Pustakena, Pustakata, and then Jnanam, Jnanena, Jnanata. We can use any of these and all are correct. And it can be used interchangeably. There is no rule like when we should use Dvitiya Vibhakti, when we should use Tritiya or Panchami with respect to Vina Shabda. So all three are correct answers. Sure.
Thank you.
Okay, so with this we complete the revision and at least some portions of the chapter Nadi, the lesson Nadi that we had learned. I request all of you to please read through the slides, I mean read the lesson at least a few times so that you will know like for the fill in the blanks or for the question and answers etc. It is easier for you to know what exactly is the answer. So please practice and please complete doing these exercises, okay?